Hey, what's up guys, myself Swapnil Srivastava and welcome back to YouTube channel. Many of you have seen this award winning CGI animated short film, that is Agent 327 Operation Barbershop, which is entirely produced with the help of Blender. And if you have not seen this, just check the link in description. So the point here is that what if I say that the software which were used for creating this masterpiece can be run on the device that you are holding on your hand right now. And this video is all about it. So as I previously had made a video on this topic, that how to run .exe files on Android phone, and that method is not that much useful. You can't run any heavy PC softwares, but in this video I'm going to tell you how you can run heavy PC softwares. For example, you can run the Blender, MS Office, Adobe Photoshop, FL Studio, Virtual DJ. So I'm going to give the whole demo of it. Even I'm going to show you the Blender. I will just install it and run it, and even I will make a project in that Blender software. I will open and install the MS Office, and I will open and install the Adobe Photoshop, and even you can use the FL Studio Virtual DJ using the same process. Okay guys, so before starting this video guys, I have a small request to all of you. I'm going to make a Q&A video for all of you. So if you have any question, anything regarding my videos, my personal life, or about my earning, or anything that you want to know, you can just comment down below in the description. I will make a separate video regarding this topic, and I will pick some best questions from all of your comments, and I will make a separate video on that topic. Okay, so now let's start this video without wasting any more time. So guys, first of all, you need to download some files. So the first file is the APK file of the Xcar, the second will be the OBB file of the Xcar, and third will be the file which is required to make Xcar to support OpenGL, which will be very much helpful to run any graphic intensive software. Okay, so first of all, just go to description and download all this file. Here you can see, so these are the files that you need to download. Okay, so the first one is the OBB file of the Xcar. So, and the second one is the Wine D3D for Windows file, which is going to very much helpful for us to enable the OpenGL in the Xcar. So it will make Xcar to support the OpenGL softwares. And now the third one is the Xcar APK. Okay, so first download all this file and just follow all the steps that I'm going to show you. So now the first thing you need to do is just copy this OBB file and paste it in your internal storage, and go to the Android and go to the OBB file and just paste it here. Okay, and after that just open this APK file, click on the install, and after the installation click on the open. So the Xcar is not a free app, it is required you to buy a plan to use it, but because of the Akira Yuki who modded this app and help us to make it usable for everyone without buying any plan, so I'm very much thankful to Akira Yuki for modding and making the correct version of this Xcar app. So now just open it, click on allow. You can see now it's starting up and it's unpacking everything, and it will ask you to wait for some time here. Okay, now the next thing you need to do is just go to the manage containers and click on this plus sign and just add a container here. Which is going to be useful for us because it will launch the desktop of the Windows, and from there you can just open the file explorer and install any exe file. So I'm going to show everything here, so don't worry. So after that, just click on these three dots and click on the properties. Now here just go to the screen resolution and select 1280 multiplied by 720, which is the 16:9. And in the color depth select 32-bit, and in the controls let it to be default. After doing all this thing, also do one check here, the last option. So after doing all this thing, just go back and click on the Run Explorer. You can see starting up, so it will start the desktop of the Windows. You can see it's showing the default controls settings, so that you need to know. So if you just do the short tap, it will be equivalent to the left click of a mouse, and if you do the long tap and release, it will be equivalent to the right click of a mouse, and if you want to do the vertical scroll, you simply need to just short tap and move. So you can just read all this thing regarding the controls, and after that you can see it's opened the explorer, which is the file explorer through which you can install the application that you want to install. Now before doing this, just go to the start. Here you can see, Now just let me zoom through it and click on the start, click on the run, and here you need to click on the open and click on this keyboard icon, and you need to type wine cfc. Okay, and now click on the OK. Here you can see it will open like this. Now just click on Windows XP and select the Windows 10 here. Now click on the apply and click on the OK. Okay, so these are the first few steps that you need to do. Now the next thing you need to do is just to copy and paste some files which is required to make this Xcare to support OpenGL. So for example, if you want to run Blender or any other software which require DirectX components, so for that purpose you need to make this Xcare to support OpenGL. Okay, so to solve this issue, you simply need to go to the folder where you put it all the downloads file. For example, you can see the files which are showing here is actually the files of my download folder. You can see when I go to the file manager and when I go to the internal storage and when I go to the downloads, you can see, so all the files which is showing here is actually there. So these are the file which is visible here. So in the same manner, you can also copy and paste all those files that you want to access in the Xcare. So just copy it, paste it in the download folder, and here you can see I'm going back to the OpenGL. And now here you need to go to this folder which is wine3dd for Windows. As I already told you, you will find the file link in the description, so just download this folder from there. And after going here, just long tap and move up your cursor to copy, to select all the files, and just and tap on the screen and keep tapping it for the few seconds and leave it there. You will see the copy option. Just click on that copy option and just go to the local disk C, and from here go to the Windows, click on the double click on it, and now in the system 32, just open it by double clicking, and here you need to paste these files. So to paste these files, just simply you can select this paste option. Here you can see it's copying all this thing. So it will ask you to whether you want to replace these files with the new one or not. So just click on the yes. Okay, so when all this thing will be completed, you need to go back to the folder where you from where you copied all this file. You can see, let me go back. Okay, so this was the folder. Now you can see these are the files which I copied there. So now to make it functional, you simply need to go to the start, go to the run again. Now again open the wine cfz, okay, let me just do it correctly. Okay, now click on the OK, and after doing this, just go to the libraries, and here you need to do one thing. Just type on the new override library, just click on this and open the keyboard here, and now you have to just follow all the steps that I'm going to show here. So just type here d3d 10 and click on the add. Now again type d3d 10 and core. So what actually I'm doing here is that I'm just copying the name of the file and just writing it here. So just write all the names of the files that you copied in the system32 folder and just save it. Okay, so you can see just copy, I'm just writing all the names of the files. So this is the d3d 10 core, and I will click on the OK. Now the next one is the d3d 10, now one d3d 10 one. Now the next one is the d3d 11, click on add. Next one is d3d 8, add. d3d 9, add. dd RAW add so in this so while adding this one you will ask to changing the load order of this library is not recommended. Are you sure you want to do this? So just simply click on the yes and now go back to add the next one, which is the DXGI. Click on the add. Now the next one is LIB wine, live wine, add, open GL 32, open GL 32 and click on the add. Now again click on the yes. Now the only few are left here, which is wine, D3D, wine D3D. So this one is the last one, and you can see this one is the TXT file, not a DLL file. So you need to just write the names of all the DLL files which you just copied to the system32 folder. Here you can see. So just add all those files names here, and this one is the last one. I will click on the add and I will just click here yes. Okay, and after that just click on this apply and click on the okay. So now you are good to go to download and install any software that you want. Now it will not give any OpenGL error. For example, now I'm going to install the Blender. Okay, so when the Explorer will open, just go to the folder which is the download folder, which is a local disk T, and here select a file that you want to install. I'm going to install a Blender, so I will select a Blender 2.79, and I will also suggest you to install this version. Click on the open, so it will open the setup here. You can see. Okay, so you can see now you have to click on the next and just click on this I accept the license agreement and click on the next, and now again click on the next and click on the install. So it will take little bit of time to install this software. So the same way you can do to install all the other software that you want to use in this Xgear app. Okay, so here you can see it's completed the setup. Now click on the finish and now go to the start. Click on the program, click on the Blender, click on this Blender. Here you can see now it will start the Blender on your Xgear app. So if you had not followed the previous step that I shown you to copy all those DLL file to the system32 folder and after just writing all those name to the system environment, so if you had not followed that step, the Blender will not be able to run. And it is most important part, because if you also want to run any graphic required software, for example Blender or Unity, you need to do this step. Okay, so after doing that step, you need to download and install any other software. So you can see it's opening up. So you can see this is the Blender 2.79. So I will recommend you to use this version, it is more stable. So here you can see, now I will click anywhere, and now you can see I can just pinch and zoom. I can go to the file, go to the render, and even I can select different tools here. So let me do, so let me show you something here. Okay, so before doing anything, let me turn on the touch. Now you can see wherever I'm tapping, it's showing a symbol here, so you can just recognize that where I'm tapping or where I touching on my screen. So now you can see, now if you want to zoom in this app, you just simply need to swipe like this. And if you want to zoom in the Blender, so just use your two fingers here. So just use your one finger here and just do like this. You can see I can just zoom in and zoom out. Okay, so just let me give you a demo here. Just click on this object mode and go to the edit mode. Here you can see, so now the whole object is selected. Now let me go to the face select option, and now I'm going to select one face of the cube. Here you can see one face is selected, So now I'm going to use the extrude tool, which you can find in the tools option. Here you can see this is the tools option, and in the tools you can see there is an extrude option. Okay, so first let me zoom out from here. Okay, now click on this extrude region and now just swipe up to see the changes. You can see it's running very fluently here. Now again I can go and select the next face here. Now again select the extrude region, and after that I again just extrude this part of the cube. So similarly you can use this tool, you can do your small projects in this app, and you can make any 3D model that you want, and all this thing is running on your smartphone. First of all let me close this Blender, click on this cross and just click on the OK. Now I'm going to install the Adobe Photoshop. So you can see the installation process is completed. So click on the finish, and now again I will go to the start and go to the program, and you can see the Adobe. Now click on the Adobe Photoshop CS4. Okay, so it will open the Adobe Photoshop on your smartphone, which is the full PC version, and you are using it on your smartphone. Okay, it's now fully open. So after it will be opened fully, it will not lag anymore. Just click on the file, it will open. Click on the edit, it will open. So click on the file and open any image file, and you can start editing from here. Okay, so this is the Adobe Photoshop. Now the last one I will like to show you is the MS Office. Can see this is the setup of the MS Office. Now click on the setup, click on the open. Click on the continue, which you can do later also. Just click on this accept and click on the continue. Now click on install now. So it is installing the Microsoft Office Ultimate 2007. It will take little bit of time. See, the installation process is completed. Now you need to click on this cross and go to the start and go to the programs, and here you can see you will find the Microsoft Office. Now click on this and you will find all the Microsoft Office tools. For example, you can go to the Excel or the PowerPoint or MS Word. So I'm going to open the MS Excel. So you can see it's running very smoothly. Let me click on the insert. You can see all the important tools is present here, and you can go to the page layout, you can go to the formulas, you can go to data. So with the help of an OTG cable you can connect keyboard and mouse, and you will be good to go wherever you want. You can use this MS Office with your smartphone. So let me close this one. Thanks guys for watching this video. I hope you liked it, and if you have any confusion or any question you can just comment on below. So thanks guys for watching this video. Have a good day, good luck, and bye. Take care.